Hello, I'm Danny, and this is my nomad family.
We are living on our sailboat since 3 years.
And now we're going for a real adventure.
We choose to leave everything we had and to explore the art of living differently.
The worst place to vlog.
I know!
Our weekly videos give you a peek into our nomad life. Join our adventure today by subscribing and hitting the bell button. Thanks.
So we're anchored over here in Falmouth Harbor, but today we decided to explore English Harbor and we will have a little walk to the other side to discover it.
After exploring Antigua's east coast, we arrived to the south. We are anchored just in front of the Pigeon Beach. And today, we will explore the last Georgian shipyard in the world.
Are you ready for the adventure?
Yes!
So you already walked this way this morning?
Yes.
She didn't make us pay. Normally you pay the entrance, right?
Yes.
But since Marvin...
Because we are not at anchor immediately.
Yes, I love you so much.
Yes, okay. She loves you guys. So this place is called Nelson's Dockyard and it was built in the 19th and 18th century by the British. Very, very cute place. Okay.
Yes.
What do you have to say about this tree?
Ah, maybe I need to watch again the series on Netflix to see.
Yes.
Plant the tree.
Ah yes, we don't remember this one. Considered to be UNESCO World Heritage since 5 years. It's a protected area. And as I was saying, the English found that it is a very good strategic point because one, it is protected from hurricanes because of its position in English Harbor. And second thing is that they could watch French from up here. Now we're going for a real adventure with our stroller. I don't know if you will hear me because there's this thing over here making a horrible noise, but over here behind me you have the anchorage of English Harbor and it seems very, very nice. We heard that it's completely full every time and they told us that the Pigeon Point Beach... Yes, I'm serious. I told them that they won't hear me.
The worst place to vlog.
Look. I know, I showed them, but they will see the anchorage.
Knowing that you enjoy our videos is important to us, so please do hit that like button if that's the case.
Okay, woo. So we'll have the stroller. One thing, guys, this is our first foreign country. because Spain, Portugal was still in Europe and we had our French coverage, and then Guadeloupe is French. So this is the first time since 2.5 years that we had to think about medical coverage. What?
You have to come with us.
I have to come with you?
Yes.
Okay, let's go. But I'm scared to fall in love again. Scared to fall in love again. Next time we really, really have to anchor over here.
Yes.
Do you think we can arrive here with the dinghy? No.
Maybe a day like this, but not with this one.
I was talking about traveling medical insurance earlier, but Marvin is the one who did all the research. So maybe it's better if he's here with us. Where did you find Czapka?
On Google.
Okay.
Travel Assurance.
Travel Insurance. It's a French company, but they are operating in an international level and their website is translated in English, so you can check it out. And what we found really, really good is that there's this pack which is really adapted to travelers, families, and people who travel the world for longer periods. So it has to be at least 3 months.
For our contract, it's 3 months to 24 months.
Yes, so it is maximum 2 years.
Czapka's Cape Adventure is an insurance formula extremely adapted to our nomad life. The advantages are numerous. You can check out their webpage and explore what they're offering.
We hope never to use it.
Yes. Yes. But just in case.
We already went to the hospital.
We went to the hospital with Sarah.
Two times.
Yes.
One time for me.
So, yes. We have to be covered, just in case, right? It's better. Let's go back. Woo, the day was long.
Look how many.
How many what?
We are a small family YouTube channel and we do everything ourselves. If you appreciate our work, one way to show it is by simply leaving a comment. Thank you.
Yes.
Did you get a good night's sleep?
Yes.
How many hours do you need to prepare the boat for sailing?
This morning, 2 hours.
Hello, everyone. I'm completely exhausted. So Marvin did all the work this morning. And I woke up at 7:30 with Soan. Well, breastfeeding is very, very beneficial and good, but it is tiring.
Yes. Where's my little baby? But ciao. Mama, ti snima sa ovom velikom kamerom. Gde si kod nečo mala? Marvin is already hoisting the sails. I'm late.
What's the technique?
Set here. Before I unfurl the Genoa.
Isn't this line too short?
Yes, too short.
We need to change our running rigging.
Yes.
ain't the one. This hydro wing thing is just crazy. It is completely incredible. We just having fun, fun, fun. Does it take a lot of time to install it?
No, when we don't forget, no.
Ah, okay, but why didn't we put it?
Upwind, I'm not very happy. Upwind.
Ah, okay. Yeah, so downwind is better, right? Yes. So today it is very, very good. And it feels like floating. It is so much more delicate than the autopilot. It is very, very gentle and good, good sensations. There's this new... Wow, what was that? What was that? We hit something. Ça c'était pas bien du tout. Oh my god!
Minute française. Je me suis blessé à des en sortant de l'annexe. J'ai attaché l'annexe à un endroit où il y avait un grand muret qui m'arrivait à peu près, je sais pas moi, aux épaules. Et en débarquant, j'ai mis le pied gauche sur le muret. J'ai senti un gros claque et j'ai eu une grosse douleur qui m'a fait me rouler par terre. On est parti à l'hôpital juste pour faire une radio, et écarter le fait que la hanche soit luxée, qu'il n'y ait pas de soucis. Ça ressemble à un gros claquage d'un des muscles, je pense que c'est l'adducteur ou un autre muscle autour, parce que j'ai eu un bleu sur toute la cuisse. Et du coup, pour récupérer, j'ai appliqué le protocole RICE. Donc le repos, bah, c'est pour se reposer. Hein. Vraiment laisser au corps le temps de se reposer du choc, déjà les premières 48 heures pour qu'il se décontracte un petit peu, parce qu'il y a tout un mécanisme de protection qui se met en place. Donc ensuite, il faut glacer. Hein. On glace au maximum, pas plus de 20 minutes. Ça enlève la douleur, ça aide à faire circuler le sang, ça fait un apport de sang frais qui aide à récupérer plus vite. Et la compression, c'est mon petit custom, c'est une floss band, ça s'appelle, ou une vaudou band. Et ça sert à compresser donc les endroits traumatisés, ça peut être muscle ou articulation. C'est pas mal à avoir à bord d'un bateau. De l'extrémité vers le cœur, on coince. On attend 2 minutes maximum. Pas plus, hein, faut pas que ça fasse garrot. Voilà. On explique ce protocole parce qu'on peut se blesser de différentes manières sur un bateau. Donc tu vois la couleur là. Et donc élévation, au maximum élever la jambe. Peut-être que je vais mettre 6 à 8 semaines à guérir si je ne prends pas soin de ma blessure. Et peut-être que je vais mettre 5 à 6 semaines à guérir en faisant la compression, en faisant le RICE. Blood on my fingertips and words on my tongue. So many verses, I wish I would have sung.